Hello, and welcome to the Shoreline Community College Library, also known as the Ray Howard Library. The Shoreline Community College Library staff want to welcome you to the college and also give you a brief orientation to the resources and services that are available online and in person. So to get started, the library is located in the 4000 building on campus, basically right in the middle of campus. So if you're looking at a campus map, or if you're walking around and looking at the different building numbers, you want to look for the 4000 building. We're on the second floor. And our hours during the academic year, which includes fall, winter, and spring quarters, we're open from 8 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and 8 a.m. to 4:30 p.m. on Fridays. In the summertime, we might close a little bit earlier at 5 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and then we're usually closed on Fridays in the summer. So, what are some things that you can do in the library? So, of course, you can stop by, maybe take a break in between classes, get some work done. In addition to that, we also have group study spaces available. So we have quiet study spaces. We also have reservable study rooms. So if you wanted to practice a presentation with your group, we do have rooms that you can reserve online. In addition, we also have printing and computers. You can print in black and white and also in color. We have books, movies, magazines, graphic novels, board games, and more that you can check out from the library. We also have phone charging stations available in the library. And also a makerspace. So if you want to get a little crafty, if you want to make a button or maybe cut up some construction paper, or maybe you have a project for a class, or maybe you just want to do something for fun, we do have a makerspace. And if we don't have the materials, you can always ask us, we can make sure that we get the materials for that makerspace. So in addition, and last but not least, and most importantly, we love getting questions. So never hesitate to ask us questions. We love getting questions at the desk. So don't hesitate to come up to the desk or ask us online if you have questions about the library, about research, about really anything. And if we don't know the answer, we usually try to make sure that we can direct you to the right place. Okay, in addition to in-person services, we also have a lot of online services available. So that includes 24/7 chat. So that's actually a live chat with a librarian. So during Shoreline Library's typical business hours, so around 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. Monday through Thursday, and around 10 a.m. to 4:30 p.m., which is usually when librarians are staffing the reference desk, we are also on chat. So you'll actually get a chance to chat with us if you chat during those hours. If you do chat after hours, like maybe you have something due, you're working at 3 a.m., which we know does happen, you'll probably get a backup chat librarian who is usually someone in a different part of the country who is staffing chat as a backup librarian. And they're usually pretty good at figuring out what's going on. And if not, they send it to us for follow-up, and we usually respond within about 48 hours. In addition to chat, we also have ebooks, streaming media, academic articles, newspaper articles, magazine articles, and more that are available online through the library website. And also, if you want to spend a little bit more one-on-one time, maybe you have a research project and you really want to do a deeper dive, you can book an appointment with one of the librarians online. So what do you need to check out something from the library? Let's say you have a graphic novel or a board game or a book that you want to check out. All you really need is your CTC link number or your first and last name, and that's it. You can, of course, use your student ID card if you want to, but you don't need it. All you need is your CTC link number and your first and last name, and that's all you need. So let's talk about why you might want to use the library website and databases for research, in addition to maybe using Google. So a few reasons. Number one, when you're using Google, sometimes results are a little bit more challenging to evaluate for credibility and authority. So often it might be hard to find out who the author is of a particular article on a website, or maybe you can't find the publication date. Sometimes that can be a challenge. So it's just harder to locate information that you might need for citations or references, or to even just make sure that it's a credible source. So with library databases that the library subscribes to, those databases already curate academic research or credible research that is considered to be more credible. So we subscribe to newspapers, academic articles, magazine articles that are considered to be more credible. We also provide, library databases also provide full citation information and also generate citations for you that you can use for your references. So that's one reason that you might want to use the databases available in the library. So in addition, Google sometimes, if you try to access a newspaper article or a magazine article, it might ask you to subscribe or to pay for a subscription. And libraries actually pay a lot of money to subscribe to academic research databases so that students, faculty, and staff at Shoreline can get free access. So that's one reason that you might want to use the library databases, is that way you don't have to worry about having one of those pop-ups when you're trying to access an article asking you to subscribe. Hopefully you won't have that issue when you're going through the library website. So it is a little different though. So using databases is a little bit different from using Google. So for example, in Google, you can type in questions, you can type in long phrases, you can also misspell words, and generally it'll get you results. In databases, it's a little bit more, they function a little bit better with search terms rather than long phrases or questions. So having a list of search terms that are related to your topic is important, or having a specific title, if you know a book title or a movie title that you want to find, putting that title in, or having keywords related to the topic of that particular book or film is important to have. So, for example, let's say my topic is, what is the impact of social media on mental health? So from that, I wouldn't necessarily type in that entire question into a library database. What I would do is I would break that up into search terms. So I might say, for example, social media, mental health, and impact as my search terms. So to get started with researching online, you can go to shoreline.libguides.com. You can Google Shoreline CC Library, or you can type in library.shoreline.edu. It's also available in your Canvas courses. If you're taking a course at Shoreline and you have a Canvas page associated with that course, there's usually a link to the library on the side navigation. So all of those will take you to the library website. And to get started, we recommend using the top search box. Just it says search the library in the top right corner. We also call this one search because it's searching our print collections, so what you can see in the library physically, and also our online collections. So it's a really great place to start. In addition to that, we also have thousands of databases that are based on different topic areas. So for example, if you go to databases for keyword searches, you'll see a long list of databases that you can also narrow down by subject. So for example, if you've got a nursing topic, you can narrow down by health, or if you've got a STEM topic, you can narrow down by, for example, chemistry, physics, astronomy, math, mathematics. So just letting you know that we do have databases that you can use for specific topic areas or that we recommend for specific topic areas. So that's just another resource that you can use for research while you're here. So of course, last but not least, don't hesitate to ask us questions. So you can ask us online or at the front desk. If you're not quite sure where to start, you can always just email us at library@shoreline.edu and we'll direct you to where you need to go. So thank you so much. We welcome you to Shoreline, and please don't hesitate to reach out if you have questions.